stuff out. And why are women restricted to go to the temple, like when they're on the time of the month?
You see, as you notice, this is the most popular question asked so far. Because many young ladies come and talk to me at universities and they tell me, they ask me, they say, Mr. Lakhani, your religion is supposed to be so open and pure and kind of, you know, very rational. So why are they telling us, women, that during certain days of the month, we can't go in the temple because we will pollute God? Pollute God, I said. Oh yes, the mummy days, you can't go to temple on these certain days. Now this issue has been bothering me, and I tried to put it on one of the Sky channels, and they said, Mr. Lakhani, you will have riots in India if this thing is shown on Sky. Because there are all these girls who will walk into the temple and the Maharaj will come running out saying, what have you done? So don't do that. But do see, on YouTube I can get away. The answer is this. I tell these young ladies, look, my daughter, during that particular period of the month, don't you go near your father and mother? Don't you embrace your parents? She says, sure I do. I'm feeling very vulnerable and I go and embrace my parents. I feel nice and they feel quite happy. I said, you answered your own question. God is supposed to be your real father and your real mother. How can you possibly offend God? This is something natural he's doing to start with. So why are you worried? You see, so you must explore these ideas in greater depth. And this is what I try to do, and I would advise the youngsters to think for themselves. So I ask myself, why was this considered to be a bad period for the young ladies? My own take on it is as follows. In ancient times, there were no sanitary equipment, and these women used to bleed. And there was no way of protecting. You can imagine, there was no, all this stuff that you see on television was not available. And they would be bleeding. So they would be said, look, this is the wrong time for you to go to temple or go in the kitchen even because you are bleeding. It's unhygienic, nothing more. And the second reason why perhaps this was promoted was simply because in a way this was an excuse for the women to have some rest. Because they had a very difficult period. So for them to stay home and not go in the kitchen and cook is restful, thank God. So they escape working in the house or going into the doing external work or going to temples and all that. So in a way, it was an opportunity for them to have some rest for a few days. These two answers appear rational for me. In this idea of you polluting God, I smile. If any of you has got the power of polluting God, then God is not worth the kind of, you know, worth any money at all. Then that God is so easy. You can pollute God. That means you are bigger than God. So you should be, you know, treated as Mother Goddess from now on. You managed to pollute God. So that's utter nonsense. It's nice for us to explore this thing in an honest manner. I'm not saying that, look, on these days, deliberately go and offend all the temple people. But I'm simply saying, be aware of your own dignity. And this has nothing to do with that you are impure. Well, how can you be impure? This is a natural thing. So don't let this kind of chips on your shoulder, you know, bother you or weigh you down. Grow up. Think for yourself. And see why it was perhaps introduced. I would simply say hygienic reasons, nothing else, is a foundation to this idea. Yes?
Do you not think that as society evolves, it builds that social
culture? In fact, look, as society, we have already evolved. But the thing is, it's better perhaps to make it very kind of visible through YouTube. So that there are a lot of young women who are really worried, and they ask me privately. That's why I said, let this question be heard. And they asked me privately, this doesn't make sense. What's going on here? How can we pollute? How are we impure? Why are you calling us impure? And the answer is, you are not impure. It's just a biological function. There's nothing impure about it. So don't, it's just that ancient times, hygienically it was difficult. You can see, you can imagine there's nothing available. But in modern times, we have all the equipment. You can swim happily. So there's no big deal about it. So I think it's important that we address the issue and put it on the public domain so people know. They can think clearly like this.